Welcome to Dr. Romish's Bird Sanctuary. It's about 6 o'clock in the morning. And the birds are excited. That's an adult magpie. And that over there is a juvenile. That's a rainbow lorikeet. That's a crested pigeon. And these lovely little birds. A noisy miners. Mannarina, melanocephala, black-headed mannarinas. And he's calling to be fed. I counted 40 rainbow lorikeets this morning. This is up from 20 a week and a half ago. The flocks come and go. So these birds all feed together. Four species in a small area. I spoke to the Brisbane City Council. I spoke to a lady from the Environmental Department. And she said that you shouldn't put plants with a lot of nectar or feed birds, because it attracts these birds, noisy miners. And she said the noisy miners chase away all the other birds, including the blue-faced honey eaters. And I pointed out that when I feed them, because they have abundant food, the noisy miners don't chase away the other birds. They're probably in the last 8 years that I've been living here, there have been more and more birds. When I first came here 8 years ago, there were hardly any birds at all. Something that was commented on by my neighbor across the road, my previous neighbor. She said that when she moved here, there were no birds. And the reason that there were no birds is that they were baiting. They were baiting these birds, trapping them, and shipping them in plywood boxes overseas. And they were doing that very locally. And I reported it to the police, and the police said, well, you should contact customs department. The police don't prosecute anyone for trapping birds and shipping them in plywood boxes overseas. And the RSPCA doesn't do anything about it either. There should be a campaign against it, because they trim these birds' wings. They trim their wings and put them in cages so that they can't fly. And then they never learn how to fly properly. And it's very important for these birds to learn to fly, because that's how they get their joy. They love flying. And having a beautiful tree like this gives them lots of practice in landing and acrobatics and aerobatics. And, well, they're not acrobatics, they're aerobatics, they fly. And the birds roost in this tree. They bring their young to roost in the tree as well. There aren't any young ones at the moment, any babies. Because you can recognize them by their calls. So this is a flock of 40 adults. That's the first. I haven't fed them yet this morning. That was leftover bread from yesterday. As you can see, they have cleaned. They've cleaned the area and fertilized it with their droppings. And that's how you do cosmopolitan green ecology. Get the birds to do their droppings in the garden.